We all know how important it is to have an attractive thumbnail on our YouTube videos. Well, today I'm going to show you a tool to make those thumbnails very quickly, and you can customize them any way you want with the YouTube slicer. Before we open up the tube slicer, I want to show you real quick this tool called Clipping Magic that's going to let me remove the background from this image. Now, I'm going to give a shout out to Joey Kissimmee. He's the one who created the tube slicer, and he's also the one that told me about this tool called Clipping Magic. If you don't have Photoshop, this is a cool way to remove the background from the image before you upload it on your thumbnail. Okay, guys, here we are over at the YouTube slicer. Now, what Joey Kissimmee has done is he has shared with us some templates that we can use for backgrounds. So let's just take a look at some of those backgrounds that we get with the tube slicer. You can go with the starburst, and you see he has them here in just about every color. Then you also can go with, let's take a look at the targets. Those are also very popular because they tend to draw the person's eye in so that they are focused on your thumbnail when they see it in the YouTube search results or even on the Google search results. I prefer to use a little bit more subtle background. So I usually go with the extras, and these are just subtle shadings. So this just gives you an idea of all the different backgrounds. And then there's just some other logos and icons that he's included in there for us. So as you can see here, Joey has put together a nice collection, a variety of backgrounds that we can use on our YouTube thumbnails. So let's make a thumbnail. When you're using a slicer and bringing your images into the dashboard, just remember to hold down the shift key to keep everything in proportion. Now, I know I did that really quick, but let's just go over what I did. If you notice, the slicer kind of works in layers similar to Photoshop. So I added the background layer, then I brought in my picture, and then usually anytime I have YouTube in the title of my video, I usually grab a YouTube logo from the YouTube website. Then I added the different type layers, and I just want to show you something that's really unique that I love about the slicer, and that's that you get this little stroke around your font. And here's how you turn that off. If you wanted to go without the stroke, you just click on that little S up at the top. But I like to have that stroke on, so I leave it on. Now, the other thing I wanted to show you is the variety of the fonts that are in here. I could use Times Roman, or there's another nice one, the Sketch Block. I think that's a pretty cool one, but there's a lot of them in here for you to choose from. If you wanted to do a Terminator, if you're into gaming, that might be a good one to use as well. Hey, I better go back to the Impact font that I was using. And now what I need to do is I better make sure I save this. So all you have to do is click the download. And then just make sure you change the name of your file and save it. One last thing that I wanted to show you here on the slicer. If you want your thumbnails to be 1280 by 720, you just click on the 1280 YTSL button. And that will take you over to a different dashboard. Now, what's different about this is whenever you add an element like an image or a new font or background, always just hit this reset canvas button. Other than that, it works the same as the slicer that I just showed you guys. But I just wanted you to see that we do have a 1280 by 720 YouTube slicer. So go ahead, guys. It's real important to get those custom thumbnails out there so that your videos get clicked on and searched for YouTube and for Google. Thanks for joining me today. And once again, I'm Ileane Smith. If you have any ideas or any questions, requests for future videos, please leave me a comment. And don't forget to subscribe. Talk to you soon. Peace.